the external intercostal muscle. Superior attachment is to the inferior border of the rib. Inferior attachment is the superior border of the ribs. Innervation is by the intercostal nerve and it elevates ribs in forced inspiration. The internal intercostal muscle is over here. The superior attachment is the inferior border of the rib, and the inferior attachment is the superior border of the ribs, intercostal nerves, and the main action, the intraosseous part, depresses all the ribs in forced expiration. The intercondral part elevates cartilages of ribs in forced inspiration. Now, innermost intercostalis, superior attachment is the inferior border of the ribs, and the inferior attachment is the superior border of the ribs. Innervation is by the intercostal nerve and it depresses rib in forced expiration. Transverse thoracic muscle, the posterior surface of the inferior sternum, internal surface of the costal cartilages, intercostal nerve T1 to T11, and it weakly depresses ribs in forced expiration. A typical intercostal space, they are the spaces whose intercostal nerves and vessels are confined to thoracic wall only. The boundaries of a typical intercostal space is superiorly the upper border of the costal groove of the rib above, inferior blunt upper border of the rib below, anterior is the lateral border of the sternum, and posteriorly we have the body of the thoracic vertebrae. The contents are all the intercostal muscles, the two anterior intercostal arteries and the veins, the posterior intercostal artery and vein with its collateral branch and a tributary, the intercostal nerve with its collateral branch. Now, what is an intercostal nerve? The intercostal nerves are the ventral primary rami of thoracic 1. Thoracic 11 spinal nerves after the dorsal primary ramus has been given off. The anterior primary ramus or the 12th thoracic nerve forms the subcostal nerve. In addition to supplying the intercostal spaces, the upper two intercostal nerves also supply the upper limb. The lower five intercostal nerves, 7th to 11th thoracic nerves, also supply the abdominal wall. These are therefore said to be the thoracoabdominal nerves. The remaining nerves, 3rd to 6th, supply only the thoracic wall and are called the typical intercostal nerve. The subcostal nerve is distributed to the abdominal wall and to the skin of the buttock. Here is the typical intercostal nerve, the course. The intercostal nerve runs in the costal groove and ends in the sternum. Relations. Each nerve passes below the neck of the rib of the same number and enters into the costal groove. In the costal groove, the nerve lies posterior to the intercostal vessels. Here is the costal groove. The relationship of the structures in the costal groove from above downwards are posterior intercostal vein, posterior intercostal artery, and the intercostal nerve. In the posterior part of the costal groove, the nerve lies between the pleura with the endothoracic fascia and the internal intercostal membrane. The greater part of the space, the nerve lies behind the intercostalis intima and the internal intercostal muscles. Now, near the sternum, the nerve crosses in front of the internal thoracic vessels and the sternocostalis muscle. It then pierces the internal intercostal muscle, the external intercostal membrane, and the pectoralis major muscle to terminate as the anterior cutaneous nerve of the thorax. Branches, it gives out the muscular branch, supplying the intercostal muscles, the transverse thoracis, the serratus posterior superior. Also, it gives a collateral branch arising near the angle of the rib over here and run the lower part of the space of the same neurovascular plane. It supplies the muscle of the space. Sensory branches, the main branch and the collateral branch also supply the parietal pleura and the periosteum of the ribs. The lower nerves, in addition, supply the parietal peritoneum. Now, the lateral cutaneous branch arises at the angle of the rib and accompanies the main trunk up to the lateral thoracic wall, where it pierces the intercostal muscles and other muscles of the body wall along the mid-axillary line. Are distributed to the skin after dividing into an anterior and a posterior branch. The anterior cutaneous branch emerges on the side of the sternum to supply the overlying skin after dividing into a medial and the lateral branch. Now, communicating branches. Each nerve is connected to a thoracic sympathetic ganglion by a distally placed white and approximately placed gray ramus communicantus. The lateral cutaneous nerve of the second intercostal nerve is also called the intercostal brachial nerve. It supplies the skin of the floor of the axilla and the upper part of the medial side of the arm. Irritation of the intercostal nerve causes severe pain, which is referred to the front of the chest or the abdomen, that is at the peripheral termination of the nerve. This is also known as the root pain or the girdle pain. Herpes virus may also cause infection of the intercostal nerve. If the herpes infection is in the second thoracic nerve, there is referred pain via the intercostal brachial nerve to the medial side of the arm.